Welcome to Lifestyles of the Strange and Exotic Random Book Review. Now, it's not like I haven't been doing a lot of reading. I've just been doing a lot of reading on stuff people probably wouldn't be interested in, which is why I don't do, you know, the book reviews as much as I have, because, you know, the book's worth reviewing, quote unquote. Brain fart. Whatever it was. But if you follow me on Goodreads at, I can't remember what my thing is. I think it's Blade Strike 2. But if you follow me on Goodreads at Blade Strike, same way it's spelled down yonder, you can see all the wonderful things I'm interested in. And you'd be like, why are you reading that? So, which is, you know, why I have a few book reviews. And I finally managed to finish this. And you gotta love Stephen Hawking. He's just a freaking awesome. And it's deep as far as, you know, you have to have a fairly big interest in astronomy or physics or astrophysics to kind of get through this book, because it is still highly scientific. So if you want like light reading, probably not for you. But there is lots of pretty pictures. So you can ogle at some of the pictures that are in here. Well, that's not one of them, but you know, like that, and little niblets of information underneath. And this was written copyright 2003, so it's still a little out of date, but it's a science book, what can I say? And with most of Stephen Hawking's books, and or this is a series of lectures he did, they're entertaining without being like childlike. He's very light. Somehow you wouldn't think this like massive scientific mind would be so lighthearted in his, you know. It's a very entertaining read if you can get through like the science part of it. And it's just, it really gives you a hint of his actual personality. So that's the parts that I kind of enjoyed the most, the sort of wink wink, nod, nudge nudge, and I was like, oh well, you know, black holes are, you know. You might be spaghettified, it might ruin your day. So there's almost a hint of, you know, Neil deGrasse Tyson. I think he's in that line of like the Neil deGrasse Tysons, the Carl Sagans, where in a way he makes science entertaining, but he doesn't dumb anything down. I mean, if you read A Brief History of Time, that's a good example, which I've got to get through too, because I got so far and then I end up getting distracted and it's like reboot the same chapter. And this I got for $2 at the Will eons ago. So, let's see. There's, what, 7 lectures. One about his ideas on the universe, the expanding universe, of course, black holes. You can't do anything about Stephen Hawking without at least mentioning black holes. Black holes ain't so black, the origin and fate of the universe, direction of time, and the theory of everything. So, if you're a nerd like me and like science, definitely worth an ogle through, but it's definitely not light reading, you know. So I highly recommend this or anything by Stephen Hawking, basically. I mean, it's enjoyable, and you get even, it seems like when you're going through like these long, hard, like trying hard to digest what he's saying, he'll say something light or witty and it just makes you like, oh, okay, and then you can kind of get through it. It's like so timed perfectly. I don't know, it's just, I love Stephen Hawking, and reading his stuff is hard yet enjoyable. So, yes, definitely pick it up. And, of course, the pretty shiny packaging kind of got me too. So, woo-hoo. Now I gotta find a home for him. Thank you for watching. Do remember to comment, rate, share, and subscribe. There's always room for one more at The Strange and Exotic. See you next time, and happy reading!